Hello, Leos. This is your November prediction. Let's see what do we have for you in the month of November. First of all, your overall energies, your first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth house, ninth, tenth, eleventh, and twelfth house. Okay. So your overall energy in the month of November, you will take a rest. Maybe you are planning some vacation, a retreat. You want to think about your life, to chill a little bit. You don't want any stress. You don't want to be in the center of the events or in the center of attention. You just want to be in some quiet place and take a rest with your thoughts. So let's see how you will appear in the month of November. You will appear as somebody who is really wise. You are following some sort of rules. You don't like to go outside the norms, and you are a very traditional person. Maybe you will be able to give advice to other people and to lead them. So you will be somebody who is highly respected in the month of November, and people will turn to you for advice, to seek your point of view on specific situations and problems. What will be your financial situation in the month of November? Pretty good. You're building your career, you're earning money, and you will start increasing your financial flow. So there will be also other people who will help you. Maybe you are working in a team. And let's find some information about your communication in the month of November and your siblings, if you have any. You will communicate in a very emotional way. You will be able to be emotional available and to control your emotion at the same time. So you will be very good advisor also in terms of emotional advice. And if you have siblings, you will be able to communicate with them in a very emotional and emotionally grown manner. Your fourth house, the house of your home, there's some movement there. Maybe you are changing your home, the place you are living right now. And I see that there's a lot of going on there, a lot of movement. So you have to keep the situation under control. Maybe you are planning to move to another place, but you have to keep under control everything. And this is the advice to decide what's exactly that you want. Maybe it's a combination between two things. You just have to make sure that you are not losing the control over the situation in your house. your fifth house, which is the situation, which is the house that shows your children, if you have any, or people you love from the bottom of your heart. It shows also the way you express yourself in some artistic way. So you will enjoy your time with your children. They will be quiet and happy. You will spend a pretty good time with them. Or if you don't have children, maybe you have pets, you will spend a really good time with them. And if you don't have no children or pets, you will find a way to express your creativity in a really good manner, well, for doing something that you really enjoy doing. Maybe when you are alone at your home, you will find some creative outlet for your creative energy, dear Leos. So let's see what we have for your career. And here we have your health and your job, everyday's job. So it's not the career, as the career is in the 10th house. In the 6th house we have your health and your job on your workplace. I see that maybe you have two sources of income. Maybe you are juggling between two activities. And in the month of November, you won't make that much money of these two workplaces. However, the money will be enough for you to cover your expenses and your to pay your bills. Your health will be not that good, but not that worse, not that bad. So it will be fluctuating. So there will be moments when you have better health, when you feel great, and other moments when you have like setbacks. But there's nothing serious that you should worry about. So let's see what is going on in your 7th house, which shows your partnerships, not only in terms of love relationships, but also in terms of professional life. So we have the Knight of Pentacles, which is showing some physical and tangible gift you may expect in the month of November. So you may receive some pretty presents from your partner, if you have any, or from your work partners, some bonus, for example, something material that will make you really glad. Let's see, what do we have in your 8th house? The 8th house represents the money you receive from other people, but these are not money you have worked for. So this could mean the money you receive after somebody's death, or some, for example, inheritance. It represents also your sexual life. Here we have a situation that is bringing to you bad memories, and you're afraid of something. I don't see money coming into your life from inheritance, but maybe in your past there was a situation where you received money, perhaps from some insurance, life insurance or something like this, and you are afraid that this situation will repeat itself also in the month of November. Don't be afraid, everything will be right. Just take your time to calm down and take a rest. Let's see, what do we have in your 9th house? perhaps you are planning to start some new education. The ninth house represents your higher education, also your spiritual growing. It could represent also your contacts with foreigners. So the Fool in the ninth house indicates new beginning, new inspiration. Maybe you are inspired to start learning something new or to elevate your spiritual growth even more. So you will feel inspired in the month of November, dear Leos. Let's see the house of your career. Maybe this is the reason why you're tired. There won't be any growth in the month of November. Maybe there will be some possibilities right next to you, but you will prefer to pass because pass them because you're not interested now. You are a little bit depressed. You don't have the energy to start new things in terms of your career. You don't feel satisfied. Maybe this is the reason why you will search for new beginnings in your spiritual life. Maybe your work and career is not satisfying you. It doesn't bring you the spiritual fulfillment you need and you're looking for. So you're not interested in growing in your career on the job place where you are working now. And let's see your friends. Your friends will be very active. They will look for you. They will contact you. They will invite you to go out so you can count on them. There will be for sure some movement with your friends. They will be very active in the month of November. And they will invite you several times to go out. Maybe you won't accept this offer, but they will be active. And in your 12th house, which is the house of your subconscious, your fears and your secret enemies, we have the Two of Swords. So you are afraid of something. You don't want something to be mentioned. Maybe it has to do with hospitals, and you don't want to hear some news regarding this. So I want to talk about it. Just I will respect your decision that you don't want to hear some bad news. Maybe you have enough power in yourself to manifest the good health you want. Just bear in mind that first of all, you have to recover from what you have experienced till now. And you have to recover your energies because I see you that you are really drained and you have to recover your energies in order to be able to manifest anything. So with the Two of Swords, we won't dig deep into your fears and in your secrets. But just, this is the advice for you, Leos. Just try to take a rest and only then try to manifest whatever it is that you want to appear in your health situation or in your life. And that was the prediction for the month of November for you, dear Leos. I hope this information was useful for you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Hello Virgos. Let's see what we have for you for for the month of November? What is your prediction? This is your overall energies in the month of November. Your first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth house, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth house, 11th and 12th. So this is the zodiac spread. I will explain the meaning of each house for those of you who are not aware of their meaning. And let's begin with the overall energy for you in the month of November. So you feel absolutely great in the month of November, dear Virgos. You feel absolute happiness that you have achieved everything that you might want in your emotional life, absolute emotional fulfillment. You will look at your life with pink glasses, so you will be happy overall. How you will appear in other people's eyes, as somebody who is really in love. Maybe you are falling in love with somebody. You will appear as somebody who is really romantic, absorbed in their feelings, and somebody who is capable to give love and understanding to other people. Let's see how your financial life will be. So nothing will change dramatically. Things will continue to move as they were before. There will be almost no movement, and maybe you will be a little bit bored with this. However, this is the situation you have. You cannot change it. You cannot force it. So your finances will move slowly. If you have investments, there won't be sudden movements, nor in up nor in down. No downtrends or uptrends will be expected in the month of November for your investments, Virgos. Let's see your communications. If you have had arguments with somebody in your past, in the previous months, in the month of November, you will be able to make peace with these people. You will feel more relaxed in your communications. If you have had arguments with your siblings, everything will go smoothly. If your siblings have had any issues in the month, in the previous months, in the month of November, they will be able to fix the things, and they will move out from troubled waters. Your fourth house, which is your home, things will get clear there. It could be literally you get more light into your home. If you're planning to purchase some, for example, lights for your home, it will be really nice. I see also love and joy in your home. There will be also some children playing. Maybe if you don't have your own children, there will be other guests that will come into your life. However, the overall atmosphere in your house will be very good and warm. You will feel like you are at home in every sense of these words. So let's see your fifth house, which is the house of your children, if you have any. So if you have children, they will fight between them. It's not something unusual for children. So they will have some small conflicts, competition between them. If you don't have children but you're doing some creative activities, there will be a lot of competition and conflicts in this field of your life. So this will make your everyday life a little bit more difficult, but there's nothing serious. The Five of Wands is a minor arcana card, so even if your children are creating some troubles, this is not something unusual or something that you should worry about. Furthermore, this is a monthly prediction just for the month of November. Let's see your sixth house. The sixth house is actually the house of your sign. So we have the job and the health. The job where you are employee, you're not making career, and your health. Here we have a recommendation for you, dear Virgos, to seek advice for your health. So it will be very good if you consult your doctor or some specialist instead of taking care of your health by your own and self-diagnosing yourself, something like this. I know that you like to self-educate yourself in terms of health. However, it is recommended to consult the entity, some health entity, for example, a hospital, a professional, and not doing researches on yourself. This is also in terms of your job. Don't take initiative on your own before consulting first somebody who is more experienced and somebody whose job is to give you advice exactly in this regard. Let's see your seventh house, which is the house of your partnerships. In terms of love and in terms of profession. And I see that maybe you are single, or maybe your partner is a little bit older than you, somebody who is really wise, and this person likes to stay a little bit on a distance. They are taking like they like to do things that they are interested in. And they are not quite the type of person who is ready for partnership. And the Hermit is also the card ruled by your sign. So we have the characteristic of your sign. If your partner is Virgo, this will explain a lot. However, we see that there will be some distance with your partner in terms of communication in the month of November. Maybe they will have to go away for some period of time, and this will make you feel a little bit isolated and lonely. However, the prediction, remember, is only for the month of November till now. Let's see, what do we have in your eighth house? The eighth house is naturally ruled by the Scorpio sign. It indicates things that you don't see, but most of all, your sexual life and also money you receive from other people. It could indicate also some debts, endings, but I see that there's some secrets secret. I don't know if it's an affair or something that will tempt you. And this is also related to the fact that your partner is away. It's a distance from you. And you might be tempted to start some hidden sexual relationship with somebody who is tempting you. So this is the information we have for you for your sexual life in the month of November. Virgos, you may feel tempted to start a secret relationship with somebody outside of your usual relationship and partnership. Let's see, what do we have in your ninth house? I see that you are working on something. Maybe you are studying for some tests and exams. You're putting all the required effort. We don't see the outcome, the final outcome of this work. However, you are putting all the required effort, and it doesn't matter if you are studying for something you are doing for in order to upgrade your level of competence, or if you are studying for university exams, for example. You are putting all the required effort, and it looks, for the moment, it looks really promising. And let's take a look at your 10th house, the house of your career. So expect some growth. Your ambitions will be satisfied with the 10 of Pentacles. Expect big achievements, big promotions, some financial flow, something really good you have worked from a long time, and you see finally the fruits from your work. So this is the 10th house, the house of your career and ambitions and things you have worked since a very long time. You have put a lot of effort and you will hit the jackpot here in the month of November, Virgos. You will have great news, financial abundance. Maybe you will, I don't know, if you will become viral or you will hit the jackpot. I don't know what is it. Let me know if you are aware of what this could be. And let's see, your 11th house, the house of your friends. You will have some small arguments with your friends in the month of November, some gossiping, some not very pleasant exchange of words. Nothing serious, but this will put you a little bit on the edge with your closest friends. So expect not everything to go so smoothly with your friends in the month of November. And finally, let's see, what do we have in your 12th house, which shows us the house of your fears, of things that you don't see, secrets, also in situation when you have to spend some time in the hospital, for example. Maybe you should pay attention to your health. You have this combination. And there are some signs, some symptoms, I would say, that are telling you that you have to either stay for a while in a hospital, either to consult a specialist from a health entity, but you're disregarding this for some reason. You are ignoring these symptoms. And here we have once again the advice to don't ignore the signs and to take care of your health, but not by your own, Don't self-medicate yourself, but go and seek help from an institution, from somebody whose job is to give you health advice and who is doing this as a professional. So this is the information, the most important information we have for you for the month of November. Dear Virgos, I hope this information was useful. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Hello Libras. Let's see what is the prediction for the month of November for your astrological sign. So this is your overall energy, your first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th and 12th house. So let's start with your overall energy in the month of November. You will feel like you're in love. You have to follow your feelings. Very romantic. You may get some romantic proposals in the month of November. A lot of romantic thoughts and communications. So your month of November will be ruled by romance and love, and you will feel inspired. Let's see how you will appear in other people's eyes. They will see you as somebody who is really explosive. Maybe you'll be a little bit nervous with some breakdowns and anger management issues. So they will see you as somebody who is a little bit aggressive and unpredictable. They cannot guess the moment when you get angry out of the sudden and out of nothing. Let's see how your finances will be. Really good. You will be able to make really good money in the month of November. This month will be very good for you. You might receive some promotion, financial promotion, or increase your income at least. There will be increase in your income and in the money you are making by your own. So whatever you are doing, you will increase significantly your income in the month of November. Let's see what is going on in your third house, the house of your communication. I see that you're probably talking a lot on social media, on the internet. You will see also increase in your communication over the internet, Libras. You will be noticed. And if you have brothers or sisters, you will communicate a lot with them over the internet. So it will be a remote communication, not face to face, but remote communication. What do we have in your fourth house, the house of your home? Maybe you have ordered something for your home a while ago and you are waiting for this order to arrive. And I see that it's almost there. In the month of November, you will receive this order. So you are waiting for this order to come and you will start making some changes within your house. Your fifth house, which is the house of your children, if you have any, they will be a little bit stubborn in the month of November. They won't like to change anything in their life. They could be a little bit lazy too. So you need to be patient with them and keep an eye on them, because if they're too lazy, they can get in troubles with their studies. If you don't have children, and we will consider this card as this house as the house of your creative expression. So you are holding to something. You want things to be done on specific way that you are used to. You don't like to make changes in the way you are expressing your artistic side. But you should also consider this as some sort of laziness, because if you are expressing your artistic side, this should also change with time. You cannot stay at the same level and do over and over again the same thing, and this won't fit your creative side. So let's see, what do we have in your sixth house? In the sixth house is the house of your job, your workplace, and your health. You don't want your health to be discussed, and probably you're not that involved in your job. If you don't maybe you don't have that standard job place, in terms of for example an office place where you go every day from 9 to 5. So you don't you're concentrated on something there, and you don't want additional thoughts to distract you. So you are concentrated on something, on your workplace, and you are not ready to talk and to communicate on this topic for some reason. And in terms of health, you might feel some heaviness in your chest. So maybe you could have some issues with your breathing. And if so, you should consult a specialist. We have the air ways here. And you feel this heaviness in your chest. So I think this is the moment where you should not ignore these symptoms, but consult with a specialist. If you are experiencing some disturbance in your, with your breathing, you should address these concerns. Hello, what do we have in your seventh house? The house of your partnerships. I see a lot of abundance in your partnerships. You will feel really loved, both with your love partners and your professional partners. So you will feel really loved and abundant in your partnerships. What do we have in your 8th house? Your sexual life. You will feel really great. You will feel like you have met the person who is capable to reflect your desires and who is your soulmate, and you experience really great moments together. Libras, let's see what do we have in your ninth house. This is the house of your higher education. And here we see somebody who is scolding you for not doing anything to upgrade your education. You should make some additional studies. You should continue studying something or finish your studies. And there's something you are missing there. Maybe you feel this emotion too, that you will get angry with yourself that you didn't finish your studies, or that you didn't learn another language perhaps. So you should plan something on this regards. Let's see, what do we have in your 10th house, the house of your career, with the High Priestess? There won't be visible upgrade in your professional life, so you will continue building up knowledge, and you will continue growing spiritually, but it won't be something that is visible on the surface. Everything will happen underground. It will be hidden, but you will become smarter and smarter, and you will be able to achieve deeper knowledge in the field you are working right now. Let's see the 11th house, which represents your friends. And we have the card of the Aquarius, which is the natural ruler of this house. So you will have the perfect friendship with perfect friends who will be always there to help you, to listen to you, to support you. They will be a little bit distant, however. So you can trust your friends in the month of November. They will be there to help you, to support you, but they won't be that emotional if you're looking for somebody to somebody's shoulders to cry on. They won't be there. Or if you're looking for somebody who will help you clean your house, they won't appear. And finally, what do we have in your 12th house, which is the house of your secret enemies and things you don't see, your fears? You might have a secret enemy which is represented by a woman. She could be water sign, so we have Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio, and this woman is she is the secret cause for your emotional anger, moodiness. She is somehow impacting your mood in a very subconscious manner. So think about person with these characteristics in your environment, who this person could be. And this person by itself is very moody. She can change her moods frequently. She can start crying without no reason or for some minor issues. She can get emotional. She feels like the victim. She's also in the next moment she starts laughing. So she's a person who changes her moods, and she impacts your state of mind too. in a negative way. So this is the information you have to learn for your month of November, dear Libras. I hope this information was useful for you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Hello Scorpios, let's see what is your November prediction and what the month of November holds for you. This is your overall energy, your first house, second house, third house, fourth house, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, and 12th. Your overall energy in the month of November. You will find something you will consider that can be potentially valuable. So you might start learning new things, invest in studies or in something you believe that in time could be very convenient for you. So you are starting to learn something new. How you will appear in other people's eyes. People will see you a little bit nervous in the month of November. They won't be able to predict your moods, and they will think that you are absolutely unpredictable and easy to get angry. How your finances will go? Very good. You will have a new flush of income. It could be a promotion on your workplace, and maybe this is the reason you have to learn a little bit more in order to back up this promotion. However, in the month of November you will have really good finances. You will have the possibility to make really good money by yourself. The second house is the house of the finances, and we have here the natural ruler of finances, Taurus. So you achieve the maximum in the month of November. You have really great opportunities, Scorpius. Let's see how your communication will go. You won't like to communicate that much with other people. Maybe they will find you a little bit absorbed in your own thoughts, in your own life, a little bit detached from them. So nothing serious. Let's see, what do we have in your fourth house? This is the house of your home. Everything will be really great. There will be more joy, more light. Maybe it will be related to this financial flow that we have. But you have great time when you're at your house, at your home. In your fifth house, which is the house of your children and your artistic expression, the house of people you love from your heart, from the bottom of your heart, we have some deception, something unclear. So if you have children, pay additional attention to them, because they may be doing something not very right. They may be trying to deceive you somehow, not revealing the whole truth, like omitting a part of the truth. So keep an eye on them. And if you have some artistic outlets, you should the moon in general is a card that is good for arts, especially for music, but consider in the month of November to concentrate on topics which are a little bit darker. So if you are a creator of content, you should consider darker topics and some scary and creepy topics that naturally goes with the month of November. So let's see what do we have for you in your sixth house, the house of your workplace, the house of your health. Strength, it will be required an effort from your side on your workplace. So it will be a little bit of a struggle. You have to fight, but you are strong enough to make it. So it won't be that easy. But if you are consistent and if you believe in yourself and don't quit, you will succeed. In terms of health, it's recommended to do some sport that will make your body stronger. What do we have in your seventh house? House of your partners. We have a very passive card, so your partners won't be very active. They will be a little bit passive, taking a rest, and they won't bother you in the month of November. And they won't show you, however, also that much of affection. Let's see what do we have in your eighth house. This is the house of your sexual life. Maybe you will have fights based on this passiveness from your partners, and you may have fights with your partner on this regards. And what do we have in your ninth house? This is the house of your spiritual development on your higher studies and and the house of your contacts with foreigners traveling abroad. So we see with the Two of Cups that you might get some long distance contacts with somebody abroad. Maybe you are chatting with somebody on social media, or if you're not communicating with anybody, this is a good time to consider what kind of studies will be the best option for you and that will reflect the desires of your soul. What's your soul aspires to? What do you really want to learn in this life? What occupation you want to be involved with? The 10th house is the house of your career. We see this growth. Suddenly you will be the center of attention. You will be the master. You will show everybody that you're the person who deserves this promotion. And with the King of Pentacles, we see that this magician is that the King of Pentacles is well deserved with this magician in the 10th house. So you will be 100% deserving this promotion, and you will achieve it in the month of November, Scorpius. What do we have in your 11th house? This is the house of your friends. You will be very well received by your friends. I see that they will make you gifts, perhaps for your birthday in the month of November. And you'll be really supported by them. You can count on your friends in the month of November. And finally, let's see what do we have in your 12th house, the house of your enemies and secret enemies. So we have the Six of Wands, which is the card of the winner. And as we saw, that you will be the one who will make this breakup in the month of November. And you will be the one who is rewarded. So this winner is you. And you will generate a lot of jealousy in other people. You will be in the spotlight, and there will be a lot of jealous people. So they won't show you their jealousy, but they will be right there next to you. Some of them believe that you have achieved your success thanks to their effort, that they have helped you to achieve this success. So keep this in mind, and just be more careful with your colleagues and with people around you. So that was your reading for the month of November, dear Scorpius. I hope this information was useful for you. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.